Hello my dear students, in this lecture we will see one more numerical on fluctuating stresses. The question is, a machine component is subjected to two dimensional stresses. Here the loading is 2D loading, means it is a combined loading question, right? Then the tensile stress in x direction varies from 40 to 100 newton per mm square. Let us say if I consider a component, on this component the tensile stress along x direction, that is sigma x varies from the minimum value of sigma x minimum is 40 newton per mm square, and sigma x maximum value of sigma x is 100 newton per mm square, right? Again in question, while the tensile stress along y direction varies from 10 to 80 newton per mm square, means there is a tensile stress along y direction also, sigma y, which varies from sigma y minimum is 10 newton per mm square, and sigma y maximum is given 80 newton per mm square. These are the values. Then next point is, the frequency of variation of these stresses are equal, means they are vibrating or they are fluctuating with same frequency. This is the question, this is a statement. The corrected endurance limit of the component is 270 newton per mm square, means here corrected endurance limit SE is given 270 newton per mm square. Again in the question, the ultimate tensile strength is 660 newton per mm square, determined factor of safety used by designer. Now here they have provided ultimate tensile strength, that is SUT, ultimate tensile strength SUT is 660 newton per mm square, and what will be the factor of safety used by the designer, right? As here SE and SUT are given, then we will use Goodman line, for the solution, because SUT is given. If SYT is given, then we have to use Soderbergh line. Now before this, we have to find amplitude stress and mean stress. Now here, as it is combined loading, here it is given as combined loading, therefore separately we have to find amplitude stress along y direction, mean stress along y direction, and amplitude stress along x direction, mean stress along x direction. Now what are the formulas? Stress amplitude is maximum stress minus minimum stress divided by 2, and mean stress is maximum stress plus minimum stress divided by 2. Therefore for x direction, what will be the stress amplitude along x direction, which will be equal to maximum stress along x direction, which is 100, minus minimum stress along x direction, which is 40 divided by 2, which is nothing but 30 MPa newton per mm square. Again, what will be the mean stress along x direction? It is maximum stress along x direction, which is 100, plus minimum stress along x direction, which is 40 divided by 2. It will be 70 MPa. Again, if I want to find stress amplitude along y direction, it is maximum stress along y direction, which is 80, minus minimum stress along y direction, which is 10 divided by 2. It is nothing but 35 MPa. And again, stress amplitude or mean stress along y direction is maximum stress plus minimum stress divided by 2 along y direction, which is nothing but we will get 45 MPa. Now these values we have calculated. Now while finding sigma equivalent, the formula for sigma equivalent as per von Mises theory or distortion energy theory, for such type of loading we are always using distortion energy theory. And as per distortion energy theory, the equivalent stress for 2D loading with both normal stresses is sigma x square plus sigma y square minus sigma x sigma y. This formula we have derived. You can go in previous lectures, theory lectures, and you can see this derivation, right? Now here, therefore, if I want to find mean stress, then I have to write under root of sigma x mean square plus sigma y mean square minus sigma x mean sigma y mean. Therefore, mean stress is equal to under root of sigma x mean is 70 square plus sigma y mean is 45 square minus 70 into 45. And if I solve for mean stress, if I solve for this mean stress, then I will find mean stress is equal to 61.44 newton per mm square. And similarly, if I find stress amplitude, if I find combined stress amplitude, that is equivalent stress amplitude sigma a, then the formula is under root of sigma x amplitude square plus sigma y amplitude square minus sigma x amplitude sigma y amplitude. This is the formula. Therefore, put the values. Therefore, stress amplitude, equivalent stress amplitude is sigma x amplitude is 30 square plus sigma y amplitude is 35 square minus 30 into 35. Then, if you solve for this, you will find stress amplitude as stress amplitude you will get 32.79 newton per mm square. Now, we are using Goodman line. We are using Goodman line for the design. Goodman line for the design. If nothing is mentioned in the question about the line, then always we are using Goodman line. But here, as SE and SUT are given, then it is a Goodman line only. So let us draw Goodman line. On y-axis, there is stress amplitude. On x-axis, there is a mean stress. On y-axis, there is endurance strength. On x-axis, there is ultimate strength. Join y-axis endurance strength with x-axis ultimate strength. And this line is a Goodman line. An area enclosed by this line is a safe zone. Now the equation of this line is sigma a divided by se plus sigma m divided by sut is equal to 1 upon factor of 50. This is the equation of Goodman line. Now put the values. Now sigma a is 32.79. se already given in the question. What is the se value provided in the question? Se is 270 plus sigma m we have calculated 61.44 divided by sut. SUT value is given in the question equal to 660 is equal to 1 upon factor of safety. Now in this equation only factor of safety is unknown, and if you solve for factor of safety, then factor of safety will be equal to 4.66 for this question. Therefore answer is 4.66. Thank you dear students. In next lecture we will see one more numerical on combined loading.